In this video, let's just take a look at 5 ways to host an API you have built on your local system on the internet so that your users across the world can access your API on the web. Let's go. If you're new here, make sure you leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon. This is free of cost and helps the channel grow. So let's talk about APIs. So when we talk about API, what we mean is an endpoint which could end in pretty much any string. You send a request using certain method, get, post, put, patch, whatever it is, and then you get a response back, and maybe that backend server, that server where your API is running, also does some side effect on a database, right? That's mostly what most of the APIs do, right? And this could not just involve database as well. This could be just computing something on the server and just returning. So that's completely fine. Or this could be just communicating with some other computer on the web as well. So there are multiple ways your API can be structured. But in this video, let's just take a look at how you can host this endpoint on internet. All right, the first way to host an API is from your local computer. And what this means is that just like you develop your script in VS Code or whatever you write and run it in a terminal, which let's say you're using node script.js, what your API does is that it opens a port on your computer, right? And you in the browser, you just go ahead and write localhost and 3000. So you might be asking me that, hey Mehul, then how am I supposed to publish this on internet from my local computer itself? Well, you can do that with softwares like, for example, ngrok. So ngrok is a SaaS product, but you can build something like ngrok on your own, but that would be pointless because that would require you to build an API to host on internet. So it's like a paradox. You want to have an API to host an API. So we can just use some pre-built solution like ngrok. And the moment you write something like ngrok HTTP, and let's say your port number was 3000, ngrok would tunnel a specific URL, which is internet accessible, all the way to your local host port 3000. So this URL, which ngrok will give you, you can share it on internet as long as your computer is running and as long as your application is running. Anyone who visits that URL would open that particular API. So this is like the cheapest way to host an API pretty much for $0, because you're literally just using your own computer for hosting it. The second way to host your API function is through AWS Lambda or, you know, any other serverless product which you can find. Most of the cloud providers offer you a serverless way to host something. And the way this works is that you have your script.js file or whatever language you are using. It does not need to be just Node.js. You upload it to AWS, and AWS gives you an endpoint on its own, right? This endpoint, whatever that would be, US East, this slash something, this would be provided by AWS, right? And whenever you visit this endpoint, AWS would automatically create a server for you, run your code, and then destroy the server sometime later if there is no traffic coming in, right? So you only pay for every request, instead of, like, you know, keeping your server online all the time. So of course, this is much more scalable, this is much more cheaper and much more convenient as well compared to your local setup. The third way to host your API online is using a virtual computer or virtual machine itself. So EC2, for example, from AWS is a full-blown computer which is you can SSH into and would be running 24/7. So this is like an EC2 instance. You have your own computer, you take that script which you wrote in Node.js, you transfer it over SSH, you run it with something like PM2 or, you know, Emacs or screen in the background, and then you just have this EC2's IP address, which is going to be non-changing as long as this EC2 instance is running. You have the port number on which, let's say, your application is running, and this is pretty much all you need to share with people across the world. Tell them to visit this particular URL and they will be able to hit your IP address. Similarly, you can use this in your own applications, and even better, if you just mask it behind a DNS A record, you could pretty much get a nice name for this as well, api.mehulmohan.com, something like that. The fourth way you can host your APIs is using something like Cloudflare Workers, which allow you to pretty much do whatever you did in the AWS Lambda thing. But the only exception here is that Cloudflare would be running your script, I mean, could be running your script, not exactly would, all the time, pretty much everywhere in the world, right? So anywhere, who's sitting here could run it from the nearest computer, who's sitting here could run from the nearest computer, and so on. And the way Cloudflare does that is that it executes your script in a browser-like environment. Instead of Node.js, you get a little bit of a restrictive environment, but it's pretty much still able to understand and execute a lot of JavaScript and a lot of WASM languages. Not exactly WASM languages, languages which can be compiled to WASM. So C, Rust, pretty much any other language you can think of. It compiles it down to WebAssembly and then runs it in a browser-like environment. This is faster, cheaper, and better because you get 0 milliseconds of boot time, because browsers pretty much run everything very quickly. They are optimized for that. And you also get a lot of locations where your script is running, so pretty much your users are very happy. So instead of your crappy one server from the point number one, people actually just run your script, your API from powerful servers all across the world. And the fifth and the final way, which I have recently came across, is how you can run your service is using something like fly.io as a service. Now what fly.io does is pretty much what Cloudflare does, but instead of running it in a restrictive browser-like environment, fly.io can run your scripts inside of a Docker container. So this could be a Docker container, and this container can spin up pretty much anywhere in the world on the closest location, obviously, of the user, right? So you don't even compromise on the functionality part of your API. Let's say it needs a native package like DNS or something, which requires some TCP handling. So that could not be done by Cloudflare, but you can still do that if you're hosting it on something like fly.io. You can run a pretty much a full container over here, right? So it's not just about your API. This could be pretty much your full website. So this is something which is, again, relatively new to me as well, where you also distribute your backend, your full backend, all across the world. So I'm still learning about this, but this definitely seems like an interesting idea to host your next API as well. So yeah, these were top 5 ways I found out you can host your next API online. And of course, the first one was just for fun. Obviously, you would not want to host your API on your own computer, but this is super important. The rest 4 were really interesting. And if you have got a powerful computer somewhere in your office, number 1 might also make sense, right? So yep, that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next one really soon. If you're still watching this video, make sure you comment down in the comment section, I watched this video till the end. Also, if you're not part of CodeDamp's Discord community, you're missing out a lot on events which we organize on a weekly basis to code. You already know the drill. Make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and thank you so much for watching.